Hi, Bumblebee and friends. Mrs. Hillig is back for another video lesson, and I'm so glad to be here, and I'm so glad you could join me today. This lesson is about good news. Do you sometimes get not good news? Yes, I guess everybody does. But today's lesson is about good news. And I want to show you a picture. If you were in Sunday school last week, you would have brought this picture home, and you can get this picture out and do this yourself. I want you to find the differences. If you look at the page, if you look at the picture on top, you can see there's a couple of trees and a man holding an apple and some leaves and some rocks. And if you look at the bottom picture, can you tell me what's different on the bottom picture? Well, what's a big difference? What about the man? That's right, the man on the top doesn't have a shirt on and he's holding an apple. And the man on the bottom, well, that's supposed to be Jesus. And the top man is supposed to be Adam, the first man. Now, we don't really know what Jesus looked like. And maybe he looked like that and maybe he didn't, because there weren't any cameras back then and we don't have any pictures of him. And when we get to heaven, then we'll see what Jesus looks like. But that's supposed to be Jesus. So that's one difference. There's two more differences I want you to find. What's the difference between the trees? Look at the trees on the top. There's a tree and a bush, or maybe that's a small tree, I don't know. But on the bottom, look at that. It's not a tree, it's a cross on the hill. And the bush on the bottom doesn't have any leaves on it. So you found those differences. And you did a good job, too. Thank you for that. And today's Bible story is going to be about differences that Paul said. And so what I want you to do is I want you to listen when we get to the Bible story. Listen on that, okay? We are still on the unit that has this verse. And this verse says, "We, though many, are one body in Christ." Romans 12:5. Can you say that? We, though many, are one body in Jesus Christ. And I apologize, I don't have the music for that, but maybe Miss Amy has it and she can get it to you, because I know we like to sing our scripture verses, but I can't do the video. I had too many problems trying to get it. But that's our scripture verse. And our new question is, what is the church? Do you remember the answer to that? The church is Christians everywhere, not just in our physical church at New Life Glenside, no, not just in the church in the United States, no, but it's all over the world, everywhere. That's the church. That's what God means when he talks about the church. And that's good news. We have so much good news today. So today's Bible lesson is all about good news. And I'll show you the picture and I'll read you the story, but first, you need to do two things. Let's pray. One, two, three. Dear God, thank you for your Bible. Thank you for Sunday school. Thank you for the good news. Help me to listen and learn. Amen. All right, so get out your imaginary bag and reach inside there and pull out your listening ears. Now, if you see back here, these are all the stories we've been learning about in Sunday school, and there's so many stories and so many good news. And we're way over here right now, way over there, right? There it is. Okay. It's hard to do this when I'm not looking at it. I'm just doing it backwards. But that's the story that we are right there. We're talking about God's church. So let's listen to the good news today, all right? Here we go. That's your picture for today. In the early church, Jesus' followers wanted others to hear the good news about Jesus. God kept his promise to send a Savior, and God sent his own son, Jesus, into the world. Jesus lived a perfect life and died on the cross to rescue sinners. Then God raised Jesus from the dead. Can you say, that's good news? We call this good news about Jesus the gospel. People who love Jesus tell others the good news about Jesus. A man named Paul told many people about Jesus, and we can read his letters in the Bible. And one of the letters that he wrote to Jesus's followers were the ones that were in Rome. And Paul wrote that God sent his son into the world because he loves us. Can you say that's good news? That's good news. Paul reminded the Romans about the first man, Adam. Adam disobeyed God. And after Adam sinned, everyone after sinned, and death spread everywhere. So God sent Jesus into the world. Adam's sin brought death, but Jesus brings life. Adam disobeyed God, but Jesus always did what was right. Can you say that's good news? That's good news! If God forgives us when we sin, does that make it okay to sin? No. Paul said no. Sin makes people do things to hurt themselves and others. But Jesus came to set people free from sin. Jesus makes us free to live in a way that brings joy and honors God. Can you say that's good news? That's good news. So God made everything, and he's in charge of everything. And we all sin, and we all deserve death, and that's our punishment. But God loves us, and he sent Jesus to take the punishment for our sins. Jesus saves everyone who trusts him and gives them life. And that's good news. That's right, that's good news. So we're going to sing three songs. And so you'll have to just bear with me because I'm all by myself. I'm going to go over here and put this song on. We're going to sing three songs. So let's see how this works out. He has rescued us. Now, this one, I know this is a favorite of some of you.
Point of death on the cross.
song we're going to sing, and this is one of our newer ones, From the Inside Out. I still mess it up a little bit, but the power, the love is good. Today, children, I'm so glad you joined me, and I hope you come to Sunday school in class next week. I hope to see you there. Bye.